Hello viewers. This video focuses on the GS1 barcode system. Let me guide you through the essential basics. In the GS1 system, various barcode types are used to encode information depending on the application. These include EAN, UPC, ITF-14, GS1-128, GS1 data bar, and the 2D codes GS1 data matrix and GS1 QR code. Confusing? This video provides you with a fundamental overview and explains terms like AI data identifiers, application identifier, or FNC1. The choice of a barcode type depends on the application area. For retail product labeling, currently EAN and UPC codes are predominantly used. These codes are scanned by the POS system, like the scanner at a supermarket. Encoded is only a unique product identification, the GTIN, or Global Trade Identification Number. Any additional data, such as item description or price, is retrieved from the market's database by the POS system using this GTIN. To avoid product collisions, a GTIN must be globally unique. GS1, a not-for-profit organization, is responsible for assigning GTINs. If you need GTINs for retail product distribution, contact the GS1 organization in your country. The focus of the remaining barcode types is on supply chain management and logistics applications. ITF-14 barcodes are used in logistics and transportation applications to label trading units or outer packaging, such as boxes. This is a code 128 with FNC1 characters. The encoded data follows GS1 standards. In the next video, I'll demonstrate how to generate a correct GS1 128 code. GS1 data barcodes come in several variants and are usually readable with current POS systems. Certain GS1 data barcodes allow the encryption of additional data such as weight, expiration date, or price. The 2D code GS1 data matrix encodes data in a structured form similar to the GS1 data bar. A GS1 data matrix differs from normal data matrix codes by an internal marking with a special FNC1 code word. The structured data encoding follows GS1's application identifier standard. I'll explain AIs, also known as data identifiers, and NFC1 shortly. Due to the listed advantages, GS1 data matrix is suitable for sensitive applications in healthcare or industrial environments. Who doesn't know QR codes? These can be read with smartphones to obtain information about a product or to register for an event. The coding methodology follows that of a GS1 data matrix. The GS1 QR code will become more important in the next few years. We'll discuss this in a separate video. In the next video, I'll explain how to correctly store data in a GS1 128 code.